Every year, over 200,000 American men hear these three words, "You have cancer." For decades, those words almost always led to the same choices, surgery or radiation. Both effective, yes, but often life-changing. The trade-off? Sometimes losing control, sometimes losing confidence. The parts of life that make a man feel whole again. But what if doctors could destroy the cancer without destroying the man? Welcome to the new frontier of prostate cancer treatment, focal therapy. Instead of removing or radiating the entire prostate, focal therapy targets only the diseased tissue, sparing the healthy parts that control urination and sexual function. Two of the most advanced techniques leading this revolution are HIFU, high intensity, focused ultrasound, and cryotherapy, sometimes called the ice gun. One burns with precision, the other freezes with deadly accuracy. Both promise to kill cancer without killing quality of life. But are they truly the future, or just another medical hype? In this video, we'll break down the real science, the real results, and the real questions every man should ask before saying yes to focal therapy. Let's get real for a second. When most men hear the word prostate cancer, the first thought is usually, "Am I going to die?" The second thought, "Will I still be me after treatment?" That's not an overreaction. It's the human response to a medical crossroad. And in places like the US, the UK, or Japan, those crossroads happen every single day. 1. The idea behind focal therapy. In the past, doctors used to treat prostate cancer like we treat a weed in the garden, just rip out the whole thing. Radical surgery or full gland radiation worked, but they often left scars, both physical and emotional. Then came a new idea. What if we could just pull out the weed and leave the garden intact? That's what focal therapy is all about, targeting only the part of the prostate where the cancer lives, leaving the rest untouched. At Mayo Clinic and Cleveland Clinic, researchers call it organ-sparing precision. It's the middle ground between doing too little and doing too much. It's medicine's version of measure twice, cut once. 2. How HIFU works. Precision through heat. Let's start with HIFU, short for high-intensity focused ultrasound. If you've ever used a magnifying glass to focus sunlight on a leaf, you already understand the concept. HIFU focuses ultrasound waves at a specific point inside the prostate, heating and destroying only the cancerous cells while sparing the rest. In France, where HIFU was first developed, it's now part of standard treatment in many hospitals. In the US, the FDA approved it in 2015, and it's becoming more common in centers with advanced imaging. Patients usually go home the same day. No incision, no radiation. Some men are even back to work in a few days, which is a big deal if you've ever met an American guy who can't sit still even after a flu shot. But HIFU isn't perfect. Sometimes the heat doesn't reach every microscopic cancer cell. That's why post-treatment monitoring with MRI and PSA testing remains essential. It's not fire and forget, it's fire and follow up. 3. How cryotherapy works. Killing cancer with cold. On the other end of the temperature scale, we've got cryotherapy, the icy assassin. Instead of heat, cryo uses freezing gases like argon to form ice crystals inside the tumor, bursting the cancer cells open. Think of it as controlled frostbite. Doctors insert tiny needles into the prostate and watch under ultrasound as the ice ball grows around the tumor. They even use warming catheters to protect nearby tissue, because as you can imagine, you don't want frostbite anywhere near the wrong parts. Cryotherapy first took off in the United States back in the 1990s, but early versions were, well, a bit like early smartphones. Effective, but clunky and full of bugs. Modern cryo systems, though, are incredibly precise. Now it's not just used as a first-line therapy, but also as a salvage treatment for men whose cancer returns after radiation. 4. Real-world stories. Across the globe. In the UK, public hospitals have embraced focal therapy as a way to reduce side effects and costs. A 2022 study at University College London found that men treated with focal HIFU reported significantly better urinary and sexual function 1 year after treatment compared to those who had surgery. In South Korea, doctors are experimenting with combining MRI-targeted biopsy and HIFU to pinpoint even smaller tumors, something that's changing the game in precision medicine. And here in the US, the conversation is shifting too. More men are asking their doctors, "Do I really need to remove my whole prostate?" And for the right patient, the answer might be no. 5. The everyday human side. Let's step away from hospital corridors for a second. Picture this. Mike, 61, retired firefighter from Texas. After his biopsy showed a small, localized tumor, he was terrified of losing control over his bladder or intimacy with his wife. His doctor suggested focal HIFU. 6 months later, Mike's PSA is stable. He's back on the golf course and, in his own words, still in the game, both on and off the field. Then there's Paul from Canada. He went with cryotherapy because his tumor was close to the rectal wall. A tricky location for heat-based therapy. He said the worst part was the frozen peas he had to sit on for 2 days afterward. But he laughed and added, "If that's the price of cancer-free, I'll buy the whole bag." 6. Comparing the two. Heat versus ice. So which is better, HIFU or cryotherapy? It's not a boxing match. It's more like choosing between two excellent tools. If the cancer is near sensitive nerves or the rectum, cryo might be safer. If the target is deeper in the gland, HIFU's heat can be more precise. Studies from Harvard Health and Healthline show that both treatments have similar short-term cancer control rates, around 80 to 90% success in selected men. The main difference is center experience. A skilled team with proper imaging makes a world of difference. It's like comparing two chefs. Same recipe, but one has 20 years behind the stove. Guess whose dinner you'd rather eat? 7. The real challenge. Follow-up and mindset. Here's what most people don't realize. After focal therapy, your prostate is still there. That means your PSA won't drop to zero. It means you still need MRI scans and checkups every few months. And yes, sometimes you might need a second treatment down the road. That's not failure, that's maintenance. Think of it like owning a Tesla. High-tech, efficient, but you still have to plug it in and check the software. Medicine isn't about one perfect moment. It's about sustained care. 8. The future ahead. What's next? Researchers are already exploring ways to combine focal therapy with AI-guided imaging and immunotherapy, turning localized treatment into a personalized cure. In Japan, scientists are studying smart HIFU, a system that auto-adjusts the energy beam based on real-time tissue feedback. In Europe, multi-center trials are looking at combining HIFU with laser ablation for even finer control. And here in the US, the big push is accessibility, bringing these treatments to more men outside of big city hospitals. Because whether you're in New York, London, or Seoul, one truth stays the same. When it comes to prostate cancer, early detection and smart choices make all the difference. Bottom line, HIFU and focal cryotherapy are two reasonable focal therapy options for carefully selected men with localized prostate cancer who prioritize preserving urinary and sexual function. Both use different physics: heat, HIFU, versus cold, cryo, and both can deliver good short to mid-term cancer control in specialized centers. However, long-term randomized evidence is still evolving, and careful patient selection, meticulous imaging biopsy mapping, and committed follow-up are non-negotiable. If you or someone you care for is considering focal therapy, get a thorough MRI and targeted biopsy, consult an experienced multidisciplinary team, review the center's published outcomes, and make a decision that balances cancer control priorities with quality of life goals.